Welcome. My name is Johannes Hernsdorf, and I'm delighted to introduce you to this year's exhibit by the MicroLED team at the Institute of Photonics, University of Strathclyde. Within Quantic, we develop high-density arrays of micro-LEDs with megahertz switching rates as a platform technology to be used in conjunction with silicon single-photon detectors for a range of applications. Today, we are going to show you two specific demonstrators to highlight our latest developments in micro-LED core technology and 3D imaging.
My name is Navid Benyasan, and today I am delighted to show you one of our latest technologies we developed in collaboration with the University of Edinburgh and Fraunhofer Institute as a part of Quantic. We named this technology Mega Projector because it is a 16 kilopixel micro-LED projector with which we are pushing towards the 1 million frame per second operating regime. This device can be used to transmit data as a light fidelity transmitter, as well as for single pixel imaging, high resolution beamforming, and tens of other applications. Now, I would like to show you some patterns projected by our device. But since our device is very small, I use a projection lens and I will show you the projected lights on the wall.
Hello, my name is Emma Lefrançois. I'm a PhD student at the University of Strathclyde in Glasgow. First, let me introduce you the motivation of my current project. Our goal is to make 3D imaging easily deployable in building infrastructures. Moreover, we also want to create a multiple access technology where Li-Fi, visible light positioning, and 3D imaging would coexist. Here is a schematic of a combined time of light and photometric stereo imaging, which is the demonstration we are going to show you. By employing a dual imaging system incorporating both time of light and photometric stereo, the complementary properties of both systems can be used to image complex 3D fields with high resolution and complex discontinuities between objects. The SPAD sensor has two modes, photon counting and time-correlated single photon count. We use the lattice for time of flight measurement as it timestamps the arrival of each photon. Now we can switch on the phone and select the super slow motion mode that runs at 960 frames per second. So once we've done the calibration, then we can use the range map to choose the object we want to reconstruct just by selecting the distance. So here we are getting the result for the sphere. The error, root mean squared error that we calculate is equal to 1.5 millimeter, which corresponds to 3.1%.